Just a few days ago, I found myself in my room, engrossed in thoughts about potential plot lines to reintroduce the Hulk in the forthcoming Avengers sequel. It was then that my gaze was drawn toward several ants marching along my windowsill, their movements strikingly synchronized as they followed each other in two orderly lines. What particularly intrigued me was that every ant seemed to touch the others coming in the opposite direction, head-on before proceeding. It's a remarkable behavioral pattern that I've noticed before, but the logical query arises, why do ants behave in this way? Researchers have put forth multiple hypotheses to demystify this curious bit of ant behavior. The most prevalent theory revolves around the importance of their identity. Communal living is a cornerstone for ants, with an average colony housing thousands. Considering that most ants lack good vision, it is crucial for them to be able to recognize fellow nestmates. These interactions, where ants meet and seemingly touch head-on, allow them to sniff out each other's scents to confirm that the encounter is with a citizen of their own colony. A foreign scent, an intruder's telltale sign, will trigger the ant to retreat to safety. In essence, physical contact emerges as an essential tool for communication and threat detection. However, there is another intriguing theory. An ant could be seeking food and bump into a nestmate returning from a successful forage. This typically triggers a unique type of exchange, a process called trophallaxis. Trophallaxis, observed among various insects like ants, wasps, and termites, involves the transfer or sharing of food from one member to another. Although the concept of mouth-to-mouth or anus-to-mouth transfer may initially appear distasteful from a human perspective, for insects, it is an engaging practice and highly popular within ant communities. An interesting side note is that an ant can signal its hunger to another by poking it with its antenna, eliciting a mouth-to-mouth transfer. With millions of members, ant colonies employ a plethora of methods to ensure seamless communication and avoid chaotic situations. Let's examine their communication methods individually. The first is through scent, with each colony having a unique signature smell, a mix of pheromones. Physical touch, alongside these scent markers, allows an ant to communicate useful information to its fellow colony members. For example, after discovering food, an ant returning to the colony will drop pheromone trails for others to follow, occasionally allowing them to taste a sample from its mouth. Remarkably, ants also communicate through body language. One mechanism involves creating a jaw reflex by gently brushing against another ant to taste its diet. While this may be surprising, ants also communicate audibly by rubbing their legs on their bodies, creating low-resonance sounds that are inaudible to humans but clearly interpreted by fellow ants. Considering their swift and agile movement, one may wonder how ants manage their body weight with their three pairs of minute legs. The answer lies in the alternating tripod pattern, where the extremities move in tandem while maintaining a low center of gravity, ensuring speed and agility. So, the next time you see an ant interacting with fellow ants on its journey, remember, it's not poor navigation. You are witnessing their dynamic communication practices in action. If the interaction seems longer than normal, they could be performing a noble act of food sharing, keeping everyone in the colony well-fed.